Hi everyone, in this video, let's go over the top 10 most essential plugins every WordPress website should have. Now keep in mind, there's well over 10,000 plugins to choose from in the WordPress plugin library, so most likely there may be some others that you'll want to add to your website. When you're just getting your site up and running though, these plugins are definitely a great way to get your site started on the right foot. And so in this video, I'll go over each of these 10 plugins, starting with a Kismet, then we'll talk about Jetpack, WordPress SEO by Yoast, Magic Action Box, Contact Form 7, W3 Total Cache, the P3 Plugin Performance Profiler, WordPress Backup to Dropbox, Limit Login Attempts, and finally, we'll go over the Wptouch plugin that will help to make your site mobile friendly. So with that said, let's get started. One of the first plugins to add to your WordPress website is a Kismet. A Kismet is a great way to prevent comment spam on your website. When you install WordPress, you will by default automatically also be installing a Kismet since it does come with your WordPress installation. And you can find a Kismet listed at the top of your plugin library within your WordPress website. The next plugin to add to your website is Jetpack. Jetpack is another plugin that comes with your WordPress installation, so you should already see it in your plugin library on your site. And what Jetpack does is it supercharges your site with features that were previously only available to WordPress.com users. So there's a whole suite of different features you can choose from within the Jetpack plugin. Two of the ones that I always use that I like a lot include number one, the social sharing features, which easily gives you a way to create little icons, social icons at the bottom of your content so visitors can easily share your content on the web. And the other feature that I like within the Jetpack plugin are the social commenting features. So I recommend checking those two out as well as the many other features that are included within the Jetpack plugin. The next plugin to add to your website is WordPress SEO by Yoast. This is a great plugin to help improve the search engine optimization of your website. And what it does is it will actually evaluate the content that you've written or added to your site, and it will provide suggestions on how you can modify things or change things to improve the search engine optimization of your content. So another plugin that I recommend is WordPress SEO by Yoast. The next plugin to add to your website is the Magic Action Box, and what this plugin does is it gives you an easy way to add a lead generation plugin or an email opt-in form to your website. So you don't have to design the form. There's a lot of different templates that you can choose from to match the style of your site. And it's a really good thing to add an email form to your website so that you can start capturing email addresses of all the different visitors that you have so you can stay in touch with them over time. So I highly recommend checking out the Magic Action Box. Next up is Contact Form 7, and this plugin does exactly what it sounds like it does. It gives you a really easy way to add a contact form to your WordPress website. The next plugin to add to your website is W3 Total Cache, and what this plugin does is it helps to improve the user experience by increasing the page load speed of your website. So we all know when we go to a site that loads slowly, most likely we just leave, and that's not a good thing if you're the owner of a website. So with this plugin, it will help to create a better user experience by increasing the speed, which will hopefully keep your visitors staying on your content longer. So I recommend also adding W3 Total Cache to your WordPress website. The next plugin to add to your website is the P3 Plugin Performance Profiler, and what this plugin does is it helps to check which plugins are slowing down your site. So oftentimes WordPress sites may load slowly because of either poorly configured plugins or because you have so many plugins on your site. So with the P3 plugin, you can narrow down anything that's causing slowness on your site. WordPress Backup to Dropbox is one of my favorite plugins for WordPress, and what this plugin does, as it sounds like it does, it gives you an easy way to create automated scheduled backups of your WordPress website. In one of the next videos, I'll go over how to set up and configure this plugin, but this one is definitely one to add so that you have backups of your site. For website security, the next plugin to add to your website is the Limit Login Attempts plugin. And just like it suggests, this plugin limits the number of times someone can attempt to log in to your WordPress website. So for website security, I suggest also adding the Limit Login Attempts plugin to your WordPress website. Finally, we have the Wptouch plugin, and what this plugin does is it helps to transform your website into a site that's easily viewed on mobile devices. So if you're using the 2012 theme, your 2012 theme that comes with your WordPress installation is already responsive and mobile friendly, so you don't actually need this plugin. And if you're using any other theme that is responsive or mobile friendly, then you don't need this plugin either. However, if you're using a WordPress theme that is not responsive and is not by nature mobile friendly, then this is definitely a plugin to check out. As more and more people are looking at websites on the mobile web, then you want to make sure that your site is easily viewed on smartphones and tablets. So again, if you have a responsive website like the 2012 theme, then you don't need this plugin. But if you are not using a theme that is responsive or mobile friendly, then I highly recommend checking out the Wptouch plugin for WordPress. So that's my top 10 list for the most essential plugins that every WordPress website should have. In the next video, let's go over how to add users to your WordPress website. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.